Damage fans, we are back here live at Comic-Con for Kids, and I'm with James. James, thanks for your time.
Oh, it's great. You're here at Warrior Island.
That's right, man. Tell us all about Warrior Island, man.
Warrior Island is an amazing sci-fi reality-based series, both comic books and TV. It's an amazing island. The island is warriors from all time have traveled there from all different times. The Templar Knights, the Knights of the Round Table.
Nice.
The warriors today, the MMA fighters of today. It's an anti-bully message. The warriors travel to the island to learn the Tiki Code. When they learn the Tiki Code, they then become protectors and don't hurt people. See, that's where the anti-bully message is.
Nice.
We want to take all the bullies and teach them to be protectors, not offenders.
Now, what inspired you to do this?
I was bullied as a child until someone took me aside and taught me martial arts. I became a Ronin knowing many different martial arts. And then I went around the world and learned from the greatest kung fu, karate, jiu-jitsu, all the greatest masters who were part of this comic book series. See, everyone in the series is actually a real life superhero, like Sifu Cliff, Helsing Gracie, Henzo Gracie, Dan the Beast Severin.
Oh, nice.
Ron Van Cleef, the Black Dragon,
okay.
Who was one of Bruce Lee's first students. They're all real people. These are real superheroes. We're making a positive impact on society by our Tiki Code. So we're meeting all these kids here today, giving them a Tiki sticker, having them promise to follow the code, respect, honor, empathy, integrity, all the things that really make this world a better place.
Now, kids out there, if they are getting bullied, what kind of advice do you have for them?
That's what we do. You go to our website, warriorisland.info, or buyacomicsavetheworld.com, and we will actually solve your bully problem. We represent 4,000 martial arts schools around the world and every state. We will solve your bully problems. So go to warriorisland.info. And we have three comics, add a coloring book, coloring sticker book, and we'll be coming out with three new comics every year and eventually have a full feature movie.
And then get that live at the website, right?
Right on the website or at these great places like the Comic-Con for Kids.
Speaking of Comic-Con for Kids, are you enjoying yourself here?
Oh, I'm having a great time. Hey, buy a comic. Save the world.
Come here right now. Buy a comic for Warrior Island, guys. James, thanks so much for your time, man.
I'm trying to come out of my shell.
I love it. I love it. Me too. Remember, guys, don't keep it nice and neat. Keep it completely damaged.
Completely damaged.
Damaged fans, we are back here live at the Comic-Con for Kids in Oaks, PA, seeing some live action of airbrushing, guys. These guys do amazing work. Whatever you guys need, they got you covered. And that's the bottom line, because RC said so. So check out some of the work that they're doing and keep it damaged.
Completely damaged! Completely damaged!
I'm standing by with
Joe Fiducia.
Okay, so Joe, I understand you brought the Optimus Prime semi-truck, and tell us about this.
So yes, it is Optimus Prime, if you don't recognize it in the flesh. It is actually the only replica in the world of Optimus Prime in that particular version, which is the Age of Extinction version. It's a truck that we decided to build as a family. And it's a truck that I chose to do because I wanted to inspire my son. He was 8 at the time, and I wanted to show him what it means to take a leap of faith in life and not be afraid to try the impossible. Because Optimus was impossible for me, but now we're out here sharing it with all of you.
Well, a lot of kids who want to like to think about watching Transformers like animated cartoon series back then for all these years, and then now it's in the real-life movie, was directed by Michael Bay. And why'd you came up with the design with the from the base stock truck to the customized truck?
Well, you're right. There's been a lot of different versions of Optimus over the years. And, you know, there's plenty of fans that don't like this version of Optimus. For me personally, I feel like it's a really cool-looking truck. It screams Optimus Prime in its design, to me anyway. It really comes to life in many ways. You know, we'll make it talk for the kids. We have it shoot CO2 out of the stacks at the top. We really do a lot of things to bring a little bit more energy into just the truck sitting on the show floor. And for me, I mean, Come on, who wouldn't want to be driving this truck? It's really cool, isn't it?
It means it's part of the smokestacks on top of the truck. It means they're custom made. They're made from scratch.
Yeah, those stacks in the back took about 400 hours and 10 guys to build. And that's just the stacks. You have your paint, you have all the fab work that was done, you have the CNC work that was done. This was a major, major project. It took about 25 people, and it took a lot of effort on everybody's part. It's one of those things that, like I said, was near impossible for me, but we did it. And we're now recovering from it and, you know, taking a lot of joy and being able to share it with fans all over.
If they have any more information, where they can go?
So they can go online, find us anywhere by typing in the words, Optimus is here. You can find us on the web, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube. We're very popular. Our story has made worldwide headlines. We travel all over the country, hopefully one day the world. And we'll always announce where we're headed next from one of those channels.
All right, back to you, RC.
As they would say in Transformers, what do we say? Roll out! Woo!